Hello everyone, welcome to another Bryce Talk Show episode. So, today we're going to talk about a couple things here. I'm going to talk about AI, the world of AI in 2024. Now, we are more than halfway into the year. It's October the 23rd as I'm recording this right now. So, I want to talk about a couple things here, more we'll talk about the world of AI, what I've used AI for, and everything. Let's get this show started. I think it's going to be another good one in the books. So, let's go a bit about AI, alright? So, this year we've seen a lot more. It's been a hell of a year for AI again this year in 2024. I've still used ElevenLabs still, because I think that serves really good for a whole lot of things. From voice cloning to dubbing to speech-to-speech to sound effects, which I want to get to since we're on the topic of that. They actually just made the text-to-sound generator, which I've covered in my second episode of season 5, I believe, S5EP2, and I discussed about the sound effects generator, and I played some samples, and a lot has changed since then, which is good. We needed that. A couple things here, too. They've updated it, and it's really nice. It's more accessible, because, you know, that's a thing that I need, is to have that thing accessible more on different screen readers, and it really works. We also have the new voice isolator, which is really good for, like, let's say I want to turn, like, an 8K recording to a really bad quality recording to something really good. Like, I had that RCA recorder that had, like, 8K quality recording, really low quality sounding recording, so I put some recordings through the isolator. And it was some pretty interesting results. I tried it on voicemail. It didn't really do an impact on voicemails. So, that's one thing. Now, I want to get to music. Because there's a lot of music AI generators now. Throughout the end of 23 to 2024, we had Suno. And that's S-U-N-O. It's one of the first few AI text-to-song generators. There's a couple that are like Suno, and there are different things, but I'm going to start with that because I've gotten used to it and used it a lot more, and yes, there are plenty more to explore. So Suno, what do? Well, you type in a text as your prompt, or if you want to be really creative, you can customize, add your own lyrics, which I'd recommend you do. Another cool thing about Suno is I can remix a song by uploading an audio file of a song, and the AI would just remix it in its own little way. For the free plan of Suno, when uploading, I guess you can only do 6 to 60 seconds of audio. I don't know why the hell they would limit that. Pro can upload as long of an audio as they want when it comes to remixing a song. So, I'm going to play a couple things. First one I want to play is the one song I made about bang snaps. Well, I'm not going to play the whole song, obviously, but I just want to play a couple snippets of that song so that way you understand.
I got bang snaps, and they're really loud. They sound like a gun or a firecracker. They're not like your little bang snaps that you know of, oh no. These adult snaps are really dope. I get them down in Tennessee, because they ain't got that kind of shit in Ohio unless you're out of the city. Columbus doesn't have those snaps. I got bang snaps, and they're really loud. They're the coolest little things around. Don't settle for the little snaps. Go ahead and get yourself the adult snaps.
Alright, so that was the one song about bang snaps, and that one came up to me, and I thought it was a fun idea to make a song about bang snaps. I want to show you the one I remixed of the Wii Sports Training soundtrack, which, if you like it, I might just put the whole song up, but I'll just play a snippet of that too. of course, there's a lot more songs I made with Suno, but, you know, we're not going to get too big into that because, you know, we're going to talk more about AI a little bit, you know. So, basically, these are what I made with Suno. They also have a mobile app, which was released around the end of June, July, which the only way you could access Suno is through Suno.com, and that's how you were able to access Suno. Now we have the mobile app, too, so we have the website and the mobile app, which is nice. Next, I want to talk about Udio, and that's U-D-I-O. Think about audio. But instead, it's U-D-I-O instead of A. So, basically the same thing. I think it has maybe a better accessibility layout than Suno. It's all over the place. Although Suno is accessible, it's just things are all over the place. And first, they were trying to figure out. I made a couple things with Udio, but I've been hanging with Suno for a little while, switched back and forth. But yeah. So Udio is another one. And, I guess it's, the biggest thing when it comes to Suno. It's, I guess better than Suno, but, you know, I don't believe there's an app for it, unless there is, but all I know is there's Udio.com, and that's the website for Udio. Yeah. Now, I want to talk about Notebook LM because that just recently was a big thing. And if you look at my previous episode of the Bryce Talk Show, I talked about it a little bit in detail, and I provided a sample based off of one of my talk show videos, the one I was talking about summer 2024, and it generated the audio deep dives. So basically, I'm just going to get a summary of it. Notebook LM takes everything from text documents, textbooks, to PDFs, to audio files, to articles, to YouTube videos as well, which will be transcribed based on what was said. And I would assume the same with audio files too. You know, everything's transcribed. You know, and of course you can get the deep dives and also have the AI in there. You can ask questions based on the source that were provided, and it does all that stuff, and I think you can jot down notes as well. And it's actually made with Gemini, Google's AI, and it's made with Gemini, so as of now, there's no official mobile app for that, although that would be an added bonus for Notebook. So I really think that would be good for Notebook in that sense, you know, having a mobile app. Because there's a lot of stuff, you know, we could do the same way. We could have the mobile app and we could do everything mobilized. But eventually that'll get here, you know. The development's just kicked off, so, and so far I think it's pretty great, and I've stored a lot of deep dive audios with it. Yeah, it seems like AI has been going off pretty well. And the biggest thing was ChatGPT when they released their limited ChatGPT 4.0 model, which originally the 4.0 model was paid. But they had the creators of ChatGPT, OpenAI, sometime, I don't know if it was back in February or March, one of those two, they released the lightweight version of GPT-4 for free users. And another big thing, we're not done yet, another big thing is you can make your own custom GPTs. And this is where you have to be paid, subscribe to ChatGPT. But all this stuff is this is what's been going on with chat lately, and actually AI as a whole. I think we've had a lot of developments lately this year, and a lot of things going on. We're excited to see what the last coming parts of 24 to 2025 brings, because we're only in month 10 of 2024. We're in October, mid-October. We got November and December, and we got next year, and we'll see what great stuff evolves over time. Now, with ElevenLabs, I've done cool stuff like make little audio skits. Especially with my friends, I would, like, clone them. I have myself. And a couple, make stuff of us talking. And I would get the audio files, put them together, all that stuff. That's one thing. And here's something interesting. I actually tried using ElevenLabs to dub music. Now, I recently had a thought this year, considering how big AI has become this year. What if we can dub music? So, first of all, I tried it, and let's say if you're adding a song that sings, then don't. Because it's not going to sing and vocal, it's going to speak to you. So, as of right now, what I would do is, if you were going to dub something with music, I would dub something that only talks and doesn't sing. Because if you do that, the results may not be the best. If you try to dub, because the idea right now is dubbing, taking the original speaker and then putting it in a different language. So, right now I'm talking in English. Well, if I wanted to take a piece of this and put it in Spanish, Arabic, French, German, whatever, then we've got that. But I did try on, it was interesting. So, there's this trance song from the 90s, because I'm big on that, especially trance, well, any kind of music and techno and dance in general, but this song, You Are So Quiet, and it was by Aquagen, and which is funny, it was originally a German song, but of course, I have the English, the original English version. So, I took that, and I put it through the dubbing tool. Now, there are a few things. I will say it was kind of impressive. There were things that needed to be fixed on that. The biggest thing is when you have the part where he starts to scream, "Why are you so quiet?" You gotta have that tone, which I think maybe something I could have fixed with changing the style, the exaggeration thing. I probably maybe should have done that. And there was a time where there was more than one speaker talking at a time, and I think that just might be the AI. But it's still interesting to think about. I still have the audio file. It was pretty interesting. But that's one thing I wanted to try to do. So if you want to dub a song, I wouldn't, unless it's just a song with speaking and not singing. Because if you're going to dub a song with singing, then it's just going to speak the words out and not sing them in a different language. So you might have to try doing that. And that was my thought. I'm like, I want to try this out. So much to be known about this stuff. And we'll see what happens from here. And one more thing. I currently have a Dice World group, and this is for those of you who use Dice World, which is by ApeA11y, or just look up Dice World on the App Store and iOS or Android. One of the things is you can have forms. You can, it's not just about playing dice. I mean, you can play dice, but there's also groups. So, I got an AI group. It's called Artificial Intelligence, and it's on Dice World. It has 32 members. Well, 31 if you don't count me. I've had that since somewhere around February. I made it, and, I put a couple things on there, and, so has other people as well. The only thing, if you're going to share content that you make, you're going to have to post a link instead of attaching a file, because you can't put, as of right now, you can't put links in a post on a group in Dice right now, as of now. Well, I mean, it's probably been that way. Dice World has been around forever. But there's no way you can post files, share files on there. So the only way you can share your creations is only one way is via a link. So just so you know, this will be the end of this episode. I hope you enjoyed. If you want, I might share some AI generated songs. I know I put one on there and that was a trance song, which I tried with Suno. But might do more of that and some of the cool AI stuff I plan to do. It'll be dope. And we'll have to see what comes about in the next month, and actually in the next 2 months and throughout next year. And this will be interesting. So thanks again, and catch up on another episode. And, of course, anything else I post. And if you watched the Circleville Pumpkin Show vlog, that was such a good time. I hope you watched that. It was pretty good. So, anyway, peace.